Hey there, my name is Niko Opevsky. I'm a software engineer here at MentorMate, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about Cordova. So Cordova is a framework for building hybrid applications using SPA or single page web applications sitting on top. And the nice thing about it is that you could use a single code base and scale it to different platforms into a native application. And as you have probably already guessed it, the most popular ones are building a native Android or a native iOS application. So having a single code base and scaling it into multiple platforms means that you would technically need to support only the JavaScript script layer. And the way Cordova does it is that it takes your web application and wraps it around what is called a web view or an HTML rendering engine, and then it connects it to the native APIs if needed. And by native APIs, I mean that you could, for example, access the mobile device's camera or geolocator. And with all of this, you would need to as well ask the user to allow you to use set features. And the intuitive thing about all of this is that you could seemingly, if you're lucky, scale your web application without having to do any extra ports. For example, you wouldn't need to write Java for Android, nor Objective-C or Swift for iOS. Again, if you're lucky. If you're not lucky, you're going to go neck deep, but that's another story. Speaking of the web view is implemented by the core platform maintainer, meaning that for Android, it's likely being implemented with Chrome underneath, and for iOS it's being implemented with Safari, meaning that all of the wonderful things that you would love or love to hate when building a web application in those browsers, you would get to experience in your native application as well. Think of it as a full screen browser without the toolbar. And that means that you would likely need to test on each platform how your application performs, and also adjust accordingly because the behavior might be different. For example, Safari doesn't allow for auto-play for audio items, whereas Google pretty much allows it. So you need to adjust. Apart from the web view and the platforms, Cordova also has what are known as Cordova plugins. Picture it as puzzle pieces for your application, and you could add or remove plugins on the spot by using the native CLI. But you should always keep in mind that you should check if the plugin supports your platform, because different plugins might support different platforms. For example, there is a plugin about creating Siri shortcuts, and we don't have Siri on Android, so it's only iOS. Remember when I told you that you don't need to actually write Java or Swift? Well, the more plugins you add, the likelier it is that you would need to ideally maintain them if they're not maintained by the original creator, or add on top of them, also meaning that they would be a little bit more specific to your application. It's relatively simple. They have a configuration file and they have source files for each platform. And with each source file, you would likely also need to understand how the platform works, how the event lifecycle works, and not to mention that you would need to speak the programming language that each platform is used with. Another important thing to remember about plugins is that, unlike the web view, if something crashes in your JavaScript layer, it won't actually crash the application completely. It will just make the view a little bit unusable in the best case. But if a plugin crashes, that means that the whole application will shut down, and we don't really want our applications to crash now, do we? If you don't have experience with hybrid applications and you're just getting started, or you're setting a project from scratch, instead of using Cordova as a plain framework, I highly recommend you checking out Ionic or some other single page web application framework that wraps around Cordova. And looks like my time is up. I hope the things I shared with you are helpful and they've either sparked some interest in building hybrid applications or even giving you some qualifications about maintaining already existing applications. Well, see you later.
Thank you.